This is South Lee Street Road.
Used to be.
Used to be South Lee Street Road. Today is what day, Phil? July the 6th.
It's 7:54. That's the mayor.
Is it?
Wasn't going on anywhere.
Well, man,
I'm telling you, man, this is unreal. Unreal.
Somebody in there? Huh?
Turn the wipers off, Phil. Keep it.
No, you better leave them on. No, you gotta leave them on. The window's gone. The window's.
Let's get up.
Huh?
Let's get up.
Back the Okmulgee River has already broken a flood record that was set back in March of 1990. That flood record crested 29.8 feet about an hour ago.
This is what used to be the bridge.
The bridge held up.
The bridge did, didn't it? The roadway washed. Darn bridge held up. Hand it to them, man. They made a good bridge, didn't they? Damn, that's scary, Phil. We standing on the roadway.
It is kind of scary. It's pretty stupid.
Ain't we? This is unreal. What's that I hear cracking, Phil?
We can get the trick ski and I can tie to a bridge and I can just trip with the current.
Phil? The stupid truck. This is something we'd probably be trying. Mm-hmm. It was in my pickup. Easy now, you keep jerking me, Phil.
Just his car that's washed off.
Yeah, I'm seeing. Get in the ditch. Easy now, you keep moving me. Hey, this is where we at, Bill. Well,
sign over there.
Sign.
Freedom Lane, Sun Valley Drive.
Why? What's that?
Stoop! You don't know where you are.
Pretty dry, isn't it? You got smudge on your one.
Get that truck pulls around.
Easy, man. Leave it.
You gotta go some other
way. Tonight.
This is
where we are tonight on the Okmulgee River. Over the last 3 or 4 hours, that river has been rising at a rate of about 7/10 of a foot an hour. The latest stage, 29.30 feet. Right now, 29.9 feet is the latest stage.
We're sitting on the railroad tracks.
Water begins flowing over the top of the levee pretty shortly, if not already.
There's one building right here that washed away.
River 21.9 feet. That's almost 12 feet above flood stage of 18 feet.
This is our town creek.
This is about 20 feet since Tuesday morning.
It's real fast right under us, Phil. See it right under you right now?
Flood crest 31 feet. It should be tonight.
And like the creek's rising, folks. We washed one building away down here.
We'll keep you updated on the Okmulgee River rising.
This is why your radio station isn't working. It's underwater. You can hear the water running. 19 going north. This is what Phil was supposed to be going through to work this morning, and he decided he couldn't make it. Down at the bottom of the hill. Water rushing over it over there. lot of water. Bill says it's down from what it was this morning when he came by here. Right there where the roadway is already washed.
Keep it down.
Colin's looking at Arnold's house. Somebody's over there dipping out of his boat, trying to get the boat out of the water.
We wanted to help him, but we couldn't get across the road.
That's right. We can't get across the road to even help him. All we can do is wish him luck. Houses are underwater out here. Bill says this is enough. Again, this is Lake Collins. Somebody's swimming pool underwater. Boathouse underwater. You can see all the water around. It's real high. God, this is what happens when you build a house on a lake. Real. This is Lake Collins Dam, what used to be. It's over the dam.
House with that boat floating up into the top of the boathouse. See how the boat's floating up into the top of the boat?
Yeah, boathouse with the boat floating in it. And Bill started moving.
Bill?
Carl rushing past the dam. I'm gonna get down there where that man is, Bill. Hey, Colin, shooting from Carl's yard. Tree about to wash away right there. This is where the dam is overflowing. Trees have washed down.
Try to get that trailer up there?
No. No.
Calling from the roadside. Yeah, of course there's enough parking sign. Should be
a trick skew over there. We could just tie the rope to this side. If his feet come off, we'd be gone forever.
You would too, bro. Urgently. No parking sign.
It'll be delivered by tomorrow morning.
That's what I didn't want you to do. Jerk me, man. You can see the water is up over the highway, up over the, we can't even see the bridge.
Every project has now become an emergency. Urgent, rush.
This is the only category. There's a car way down yonder. You see it? You can barely see the top of a car.
Crisis to crisis, and there's no.
This is the Muckalee before it runs into Town Creek.
The results? Mistakes are made. Quality suffers, and we begin to buckle under an increasing weight.
The America's Forward place, where you might want to, let's do an advertisement for Forward right here, Phil.
All the lights are on. This Friday at 7 a.m., Chisholm Furniture Outlet.
Look at the brand new cars underwater.
Rock-in weekend sale. And to
help
celebrate,
all previous Jumbo Oak Sports Club is set for
$79. Along with the Rogers, everything store-wide will be marked down.
You're getting raindrops. Focusing on raindrops.
50% off on
all they had done was starting all the cars.
Bedroom, lamp,
yep.
And
well, you think they knew it was going to do this?
Nothing will be held back Friday and Saturday. Some items will be closed out for low cost.
This is the back of the Forward place out down through Reeves Construction. You can see what remains of Reeves Construction's office right there. Underwater.
I got one of the caterpillars up
there. Huh?
Caterpillar.
Behind a viaduct. Side of the viaduct over here starting to deteriorate. Water all out there in the middle.
Yes.
You got a crane. Look at the pole done fell over yonder. See it? Telephone pole done fell. Wait a minute, why we, they didn't close the viaduct on that side, Phil?
Because
I got cars coming at you on this one-way street.
So, it's good advice. Maybe store some jugs of water.
This is Reeves Construction again.
Hey, Mike, you know what?
Comes zipping through here.
Perfect
land for it. Good loading ramp.
Can you believe in a Seth Smith? Mm-hmm. Hey, Mike, come in a minute. Come here.
Look at him go.
Look at that dog over the top of that truck. That thing is standing there. All the things getting nowhere. Mm-hmm.
Whole little thing. All of them down yonder probably drowned it in there.
Where do you see a dog?
See that black.
See him between them two tractors.
Is he on the track?
Dog got there swimming. Dog stuck out in the water. This is shooting from the top of the viaduct.
Losing,
breaking
up.
Coming up on Highway 30, where the radio station used to be.
I think it'd be safe to stay us on the water, though, don't you?
I think so. But coming through the... Down there.
starting to collapse over there. The side of the road has started rickety around what?
They ain't letting us by. They ain't letting us go up there.
Uh-huh.
This is out Metalux. Somebody's van done got stuck in the water. Several vehicles back there behind it are stuck.
Don't know what. I'm not worried about it.
Them in here, it's a small one.
Sure are.
Is that what they are? Eel?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've never seen a fresh one either.
Really?
It said pond's full of them around here. Where's the guest when we went down the aquarium though? They found out there's a lot of stuff we ain't never seen.
Already been up there and back.
Sure. Make sure. They ain't no beach.
They're not even that?
No, it's beach stuff.
Yeah, that's what's left of the phone cables there. Look how thick that concrete is and asphalt is, and watch it all over. Good job. The whole bank's gone. I guess out of habit, I looked for traffic before I went across the road.
the pieces fell off.
What? Did it? And I missed it. It's asphalt. There went another one, I saw it. Ain't nothing under you right there. Is that Leticia? There where the water level was. Yeah. Where did that come from? I don't know if that was always there or not.
Where we were a while ago where there was so much water. Now the water has subsided and we can at least cross the roadway, but you can see some of the damage that was created.
Yep, you're pointing the camera in the right direction.
You can't see what I'm pointing it at, but I'm just pointing it. See a lot of the rough water running down, probably pointing at the sky, but
that damn
49, can you see it? Now, Phil, you see the hole in the road, don't you? Right here.
Yeah.
Huh? I know it's scary, ain't it?
Yeah.
Huh?
Who's the first person to cross?
Look at it up there. I guess you could right in the middle. I guess it's safe right on the yellow line. There goes Phil. We'll see if it holds him up. It held him and Mike up. Big old tree.
Where should I walk?
I don't know. You don't know, do you? Well.
Huh?
Hey. I am standing on a strip of Highway 49. What remains is about a 2-foot section here. And the rest of it is down and falling down in the water. See, the road has deteriorated.
See, this was Northeast, but that was our pond that the dam was broke right there on the side of that old road.
This is up under the roadway. You can see as we get up on top of it. See the layer of asphalt, sand, and then earth.
You be going down with
it. There's nothing under that. Here's almost that way.
Yeah.
It's
going
to be a long
time. It sure is sinking. Gradually go.
Phil, jump up and down on it.
Make it go ahead and do it.
Yeah.
Steve probably do it.
This is a section of road.
Is it here?
No, had the lens cap on.
Oh, man.
I just kept looking, wondering what's happening.
You look that?
Better make sure you got something under you now. We done crossed it one time.
I got dollars since you can't jump off.
How far is it? Not more than 15 feet.
This is where we just crossed. Luckily, we're on this side instead of the other
side. Here's the dollars that Phil's going to jump for.
This is where Statham's Lake, the dam broke and busted up Highway 19 leading into Lake Collins. This is the day after all that mess. It's the closest they'll let me get right here. They won't let us down closer. Yesterday, me and Phil were all over this area. It was raining and we didn't have the camera. We were down there walking where those men are. Water broke through that dam, just tore the dam up. Destroyed the highway. Yeah, this is the railroad bridge, not the bridge, but what's left of the railroad tracks out on Railroad Street going down between Mayo. Tony, why ain't you anybody coming behind me? Mayo and Lee Street. What's left of the railroad tracks. This is North Mayo. We're looking at it from the north side of Mayo. This is where Town Creek washed through North Mayo. Down there is James Mann's house. You can't really see it from here, but it washed his house off, his brick house, it washed it off the foundation. That's what your Town Creek did. Mill Pond.
Daddy, you can get up closer.
This is where the Highway 49 broke.
Come on.
When Brown's Mill Pond, on the north side. As you can see, it pretty much took most of the water out of this pond. And then it took the water out of the north side, came down through the south side, and you can see it even took a truck with it. And the dam is on down south of here, and it drained it. When it broke, it drained both sides. We're gonna get close and shoot some more where it broke through. On the bridge, you can see it was built in 1947. The bridge withstood the force when the dam broke. We're gonna get close. On the edge of the bridge where it fell, part of the bridge did fall. You see the concrete down there in the bottom. All that asphalt just made a good general mess. There's some people on the other side watching it. We are standing right on the edge where you can see over. It's a little scary standing right here. Gonna shoot up here, you can see up this hill to give you some ideas to the height that the water got. That's how high the water was right there where it corroded, where it started eroding. Water was up to that level before the dam broke. As you can see, it was over the bridge. It was just washing out everything down here. Something had to give.
Big flood. You can see we've got severe erosion all over. Breaking the road there, just totally emptied the pond on the far side of the road. Back there. Back here where you see that easy chair, just beyond it, they found the body from his house. Back there is piece of his house right there. Maybe not piece of his house, but piece of an old truck that was back by his house. There's his refrigerator. Back there, and this gap is probably 40 to 50 feet wide. Eight down, that looks like 10, 15 feet deep. and moved it back, back in there. This was back where Deb's focusing now was no more than 3 foot wide before. See a little creek down below there? It's usually smaller than that. You can see that by all the vegetation stomped down, that it was, the water was that wide and just gushing through that whole area. Road.
Yeah, Sparky said it's not long in the county anymore. Mm-hmm. Said they fixed it back in and catch some of y'all's tigers.
Folks interested in some lakefront property, are you?
Yeah, we was,
what deed sale here we're having today.
I wanted to come in and put my dock in while they had the thing lowered.
Yeah. I could have got back to town out of took my
book. Highway 19.
I know.
Highway 19 is about 18 inches thick and it still collapsed.
I come by here Friday.
I figured it was going to be about 40 acres thick that they kept out of the summer.
I don't know.
What do they do? It's
more about. Oh
my gosh. The stumps now.
I didn't realize this lake was this big though.
Or this deep.
Yeah, it's deep.
I wouldn't have thought it was that deep.
In the Brookdale subdivision, this is showing you an example of how small Muckalee Creek really is when it's back in its natural bed. Now we're going to show you some of the real destruction that it caused the other night.
These are the mobile homes. This is back in, don't even run in nobody. Brookdale subdivision. Some mobile homes that the water hit. These homes were just completely flooded. You can see that one's washed off its foundation. Both of these homes here are. See these homes here, one's washed into the other. It's terrible how the destruction is. Water was all up in these things. Just floated these homes off. You can see here where one mobile home was washed into the other one. Sort of hard to drive this vehicle and film at the same time. Tony, I hope you've gotten it.
Yeah.
There's another mobile home down here that was washed off its foundation. And you can see one right here that was just turned completely upside down. Tony, are you turning? This is back in the Brookdale subdivision off of Meadowbrook. It's on the north side of the
that Muckalee Bridge. All the stuff people had pulled out of the homes that where it just got soaking wet. Water was all up and down in here. You can see up the street, people had pulled stuff out, pulled it out of the homes. All this was underwater. Show you right here, there's a car. The mobile home was washed up on this car. That's right next to the one that's upside down. This mobile home over here was washed off its foundation. There's a foundation where a house, mobile home, used to sit. There's another foundation where a mobile home used to sit. Should be a foundation right about there, there's one. Those things are just washed completely off the foundation. We are at another little subdivision off of Peachtree. Mobile home washed up through the fence. You can see here what all the damaged water did. Washed this mobile home right here off its foundation. Washed it into this car. Washed it right up on top of that car. See, this mobile home is off its foundation. There's its foundation back there. Took some sort of force to wash it that far. Then this one right here is washed off of its foundation and moved. You can see the front steps where the used to lead up to the house. Now they've turned sideways. The house is washed up over the steps. Washed into its utility pole there. And here's another shot of that same house. Smell back in here is just awful. It's just a rotten smell. The shot of the Habitat homes, where they just built 30 houses and it was a 300,000th homes. You'll see here how close it got to getting, almost wiped them out. They were just lucky. Right there in the backyards. Came right up to it and wiped the backyards out. This is a service station down on North Lee Street. Can't think of the name of it. But it was underwater right here. You can see the car right here that got washed off into one of the creeks. You see what Mother Nature did to it. Then right across the street over here, you can see where they're cleaning up two houses that burned during the middle of the rainstorm the other day. They were burning and they couldn't get to the houses, and when they got there they didn't have any water. The city didn't have any water to put them out. Me and Phil were sitting back across the road, across the water, watching them. We could see the houses burning. You could see the fire trucks trying to get there, but you couldn't. You knew they couldn't do a thing for them.
the boat dock out there. This is the railroad bridge, completely underwater. This is the bridge. You can see how close the water is. The bottom of the bridge, that's the water.
I guess they're still with Cindy and her husband. They got their stuff. Douglas and Bev came down. They worked all day yesterday moving everything out.
That's good.
They had a big storage place.
I've taken some from when I was in South Dakota.
Oh, okay.